So good afternoon all. I'm Anjali Anthony, a PhD research scholar in English and Cultural Studies, Christ University, Bangalore. I'll be presenting my paper titled Protecting the Cultural Heritage of Cochin Using Artificial Intelligence. Introducing the topic, cultural heritage is an inevitable part of our humanity, and an understanding of the heritages located across the globe sheds light into our past, which aids in understanding and developing an understanding of our future. Protection of cultural heritage is becoming increasingly important in our contemporary world as we face challenges to preserve them in times of crisis. Radical shift from a society characterized by industrial revolution to information technology has brought about tremendous changes, and everything we see around are rapidly being digitized. At this point, one can witness how artificial intelligence and machine learning have come into forefront and are influencing our everyday life and decision-making. Considering the contributions AI has made in other important disciplines, if employed in the correct manner, AI can contribute to preserving cultural heritage in times of crisis. To depict the possibilities of this multidisciplinary area of research, the geographical space of Cochin, a place that has immense historical and cultural relevance, is taken as an experimental ground. The place is significant for this study as it is currently facing a heritage protection crisis. To brief you about the place, Kochi, also known as Cochin, is a little town located in the state of Kerala in the south of India, as you can see it in the map. Kochi has a very solid historical past. Let me take a few minutes and tell you briefly about it, because the history of the place is vital in understanding this paper. Mysuris was one of the early ports in Kerala, and it was located 50 kilometers away from Kochi. It was a port where the Jews, Arabs, and Romans came. The flood of 1341 AD swallowed the life and land of Mysuris. A slit built up in its harbor, and the port's mouth became too narrow for ships to enter. What happened was a phenomenon that would change the course of history. The land across widened, and a new harbor opened up at Cochin. So as you can see in this picture, this was a Mysuris harbor, and this is a Cochin harbor. So this is where the slit built up, and all the traders started focusing their trade to the harbor of Cochin. So now all the foreign traders docked their ships at Cochin. The cultural, political, and economic influence these traders brought into the place is evident even today, and can be seen in the architecture, cuisine, language, and culture followed by people. Speaking of the colonial rules of Cochin, in 1500, the Portuguese arrived and they left an indelible mark upon the land. In their century-long rule, Fort Kochi had Asia's largest library, a printing press, and a thriving trade market. They integrated deeply into the society, married local women, and raised children who represented a different community of people, and Catholicism flourished under the Portuguese. It was at this point, in 1663, the Dutch arrived, and after a long-drawn battle, finally the Portuguese fled the town. The Dutch tore the magnificent buildings of the Portuguese, not wanting a trace of their presence left in Fort Kochi. Unlike the Portuguese, the Dutch did not integrate freely into the society, and they were largely interested in commercial activities. More than a century later, in 1814, the English took control of Kochi. Fort Kochi became part of the rest of the British Empire, and soon from a trading town under British domain, Kochi worked tirelessly towards freedom movement. To sum up the history of Kochi, the place is not only about the reign of three European empires or trading activities that flourished. It carries with it cultures that are a melange of many a flavor. Communities from afar, both from inside and outside India, like the white and black Jews, the Saraswat Brahmins, the Kachis, and the Gujaratis, are some among the 37 vibrant communities that continue to live in the area of Cochin amidst temples, mosques, churches, and a synagogue. And it's intriguing to note that the space where they inhabit is only 5 square kilometers in radius. Currently, Kochi is facing heritage protection crisis when it comes to both tangible and intangible heritage present in the space. The tangible heritage of the town, which includes ancient buildings that are of historical and cultural importance, are being remodeled and converted into boutique hotels. And the intangible crisis arises due to the dying customs, practices, and languages of the 37 ethnic communities residing in the place. It is here we can put to use the various tools offered by artificial intelligence to preserve the valuable cultural heritage of the town. AI and the buildings of Cochin. The buildings that denote the cultural heritage of the place, dating back to the colonial era of Portuguese, Dutch, and British, are present even today. Each one of them constructed using the distinct architectural style of the colonizer. These historical sites are increasingly being remodeled into boutique hotels. This remodeling adapts the style of maintaining the exterior of these buildings and remodeling the interiors to suit modern designs. This prevents future generations from realizing the historical value of these sites. AI can be used to preserve the original structure of these buildings and in determining the exact parts of the building that needs restoration. Various pattern recognition tools can be employed to perform the task of identifying and classifying the buildings according to the year of construction, style of architecture, and other relevant external factors. This will be useful for a researcher and a visitor to understand the real state of the building from the time it was constructed. It will also help us to monitor and analyze changes occurring in these buildings, in these heritage sites, in relation to development pressure, climate change, and natural disasters. AI to study and preserve the rare and old maps of Cochin. The geographical landscape of Cochin underwent massive changes throughout centuries. As I mentioned earlier, Cochin as a natural harbor was formed due to the flooding of River Periyar in 1341 AD. The neighboring harbor of Mysuris that was in the international trade map was replaced by the former. The territorial demarcations of Cochin also underwent constant changes because of the influence of colonial rulers and changing local authorities of the place. Hand-drawn rare maps that denote the geographical boundaries under different rules and the shape of Cochin before it became a busy harbor and focal point of international trade is they are available digitally. If one is to study these maps, it's almost an impossible task due to the poor image quality and time-cost ruins. Using pattern recognition tools, a detailed analysis of these maps are possible and it will provide greater insight into the cultural heritage of Cochin. These maps are also preserved in digital format to prevent it from further damage and for future study. AI to preserve the dying cultural communities and their heritage. There are 37 distinguished ethnic communities coexisting in the 5 square kilometer radius of Matanjeri, a place in Kochi. These communities came here for reasons such as trade, as refugees, and some communities were founded by the offsprings of the colonial masters. Their existence is a primary reason that makes Cochin a cosmopolitan town. One of the widely documented communities living in Matanjeri are the Paradesi Jews of Cochin. But the formation of the State of Israel in 1948 created a large number of these Jews to return to their homeland. The dwindling Jewish population remaining in Cochin are the last carriers of this unique Jewish cultural heritage, which is inextricably mixed with typical Kerala traditions and language. The customs they follow, their architecture and history are of the world in extension. The recent increase in interracial marriages and that produce hybrid offsprings are causing other communities and their cultural practices to die. It is high time to use artificial intelligence tools to document the people from all 37 communities and customs that are relevant to them to prevent it from being forgotten. Machine translation, which is already used as a tool to protect indigenous languages, can be used to preserve languages and its dialectical variations spoken by the members of these ethnic groups. A short-term project can be conducted to test the performance and accuracy of AI tools when it comes to preserving cultural heritage of Cochin. Semi-supervised methods of learning can be adopted to classify the cultural heritage and artificial intelligence can be employed in various spheres to document and preserve heritage buildings, maps, communities, cultures, artworks, etc. The history and culture embedded in the very fabric of the place will thus have a cohesive foundation to hold it all together. The cosmopolitan nature of Cochin, the existence and tolerance of multiple cultures amongst inhabitants can be put to use by calling for a collaborative effort, conducting workshops with representatives from all the existing communities and stakeholders related to the application of AI in preserving cultural heritage that is part of their daily life and finding solutions to some of the possible obstacles that can be faced in making this a reality must be the first step taken. Such a collaborative effort can ensure that there are no biases involved by feeding the data. Looking at it from a macrocosmic perspective, one could consider iNaturalist, which is an online social network for naturalists, citizen scientists, and biologists, built on the concept of mapping and sharing observations of biodiversity across the globe. In this context, we could think of developing a similar platform which uses pattern recognition and other machine learning AI tools to identify cultural heritage. It can use crowdsourcing of observations and identification to understand cultural heritage, and it can provide open data that can be used by researchers to individuals interested in learning more about cultural heritage, which are located across the globe. Users can come together to conduct collaborative projects and learn from each other. The interplay between the two disciplines can thus be established. One of the ethical concerns of AI in cultural heritage pointed out by UNESCO is that the commercial logic of large platforms may lead to an increased concentration of cultural supply, data, and income in the hands of only a few actors, with potentially negative implications for the diversity of cultural expression, including the risk of creating a new creative divide and increasing marginalization of developing countries. This can be tackled by developing a similar platform like iNaturalist for cultural heritage. And above all, when it comes to the practical application of all these, the most important aspect to be taken into account is the trust and confidence required from the public in artificial intelligence to preserve cultural heritage. The public should be assured that these tools do not pose threat to cultural heritage, but goes a long way in creating a better understanding of our past and preserving them for future. With this, I conclude my paper. Thank you so much.